Hi, we're back. I'm Gary White here with Yvonne McNary, sitting out at our tower site in central Kentucky, looking out at the beautiful weather. And an event that Channel 6 television has been covering for all 18 years that we've been in existence is the Relay for Life, the American Cancer Society Relay for Life, and the various events that they have. We used to cover it for Marion and Washington and Nelson, all with individual ones, and then Marion and Washington were together. Well, actually, Marion and Washington were together, and then they went to individuals, and now they're back together again. And Nelson County has had their event as well over the years. So we've been covering the American Cancer Society Relay for Life events for 18 years now, trying to bring awareness of the work that the American Cancer Society is doing and the fundraising that they're doing with Relay for Life. And they're fun events to cover, but I'm glad they have a point as well, right?
Yes, they do have a point. And it's been, over the years, we've been able to see the changes that have come through with the teams and some of the things that they've done to raise money for the event. And a lot of team changes. I mean, team shifting, you know, members around, and then a lot of new teams come up every year. Absolutely. So it's been very interesting over those years.
And this year, historically, the Nelson County Relay for Life event was during Mother's Day weekend, which was just this past weekend. However, this year they have decided to push that back. They're going to be doing it on June the 30th. It'll be at Nelson County Fairgrounds, like it was last year. A nice venue out there at Nelson County Fairgrounds, but they had some scheduling and some issues with getting it all set up for this past weekend, so they've pushed that back to June the 30th, but Channel 6 TV will be there to cover that. And that'll be the week after the Marion-Washington County one, which again this year will be at the Lebanon Springfield Airport. So this will be the second year in the row for that, which is a really nice venue. That'll be on June the 23rd. So we'll at the end of June, we have the two events coming up back to back that we'll have here on Channel 6. But over the next several weeks, as we're leading up to that, to keep you aware, we're going to show highlights from some past events as well. And as we said, we've been covering them for a long time. And do you remember, there are some that had some unique events, because I remember with the Marion County one, and I believe it may have been when they were at the park, and maybe when they were with Washington County, but they had the torch. It was the Olympics were going on, and do you remember that? People from around the community ran with the torch. I believe it was
Mayor Crenshaw
who was the final one along the way that
carried the
torch into the park. But all along the way, there were people doing it all along. And I remember Peggy Birmingham, too, which you've had here on Channel 6 and Kentucky Television. River Birmingham, she was one of the torchbearers, and she actually got to be involved with the actual Olympic torch as well, so she kind of had that whole year. It was kind of a nice little tie-in there. But we're hoping to look back at some of those kind of events, talk to some of the different teams over the years, and see what's been going on. So what's your favorite element of the Relay for Life events that we get to cover each year?
Well, I enjoy all of it, but I enjoy going around to each team, because each team has a theme normally. Normally a person in their family that is the name on their team or is giving them motivation to get out there to raise money for cancer and to hear their story, to hear their stories, and then to hear about their team members. Sometimes it's all family members and sometimes it's all people from work, from different employers here in the area. And then it's just, sometimes there are people who just want to get out there and do something, and they just do it, you know. So there's no one way of going about it, but it's always interesting to find out how these teams have come about.
Absolutely. And I, excuse me, I also, out here in this beautiful weather, and gets to your allergies sometimes.
Yes.
But I enjoy also when they do the ceremony where they announce the survivors.
Yes.
It's always nice to see the survivors out there and also to hear their names year after year after year. That's a good thing, you know.
Yes, it is, definitely.
That they're surviving and that the numbers continue to go up. So that's because that's showing that the purpose for the Relay for Life is accomplishing something.
Yes.
You know, they're raising money for research and development, and all the money is going back to the American Cancer Society, and fortunately we can see a positive result from all that research.
Yeah. Because it looks like they're developing new and different ways of treating cancer, so more people are surviving.
Absolutely.
We've got a lot of survivors here in this area, a lot of survivors.
Absolutely. And again, it is a fundraising event, so you can raise money to go to the American Cancer Society through the Relay for Life with all the different teams in Marion County, Washington County, and in Nelson County. But also, we want to mention We have some sponsors who help it make it possible for us to cover in the extensive nature that we do the Relay for Life events in Central Kentucky. And some of those sponsors are, if you want to start our list
okay.
right here.
Okay, Citizens Bank, Central Kentucky Flooring, Clyde Shoe Store, Pat's Pharmacy, That Cute Little Shop, Wheatley Automotive, Smith & Associates.
And then we have Rigetti's Italian Restaurant, mm-hmm. Myrtle Dean Bed and Breakfast, Despain Repair Shop, McCoy, Heaston & Smith, Attorneys at Law, Farmers National Bank, Salt River Electric, and Charlie Hayden State Farm Insurance. And we appreciate all of them helping sponsor our coverage of the American Cancer Society Relay for Life events here in Central Kentucky. Several of them have been with us for years as well, making mm-hmm. it possible for us to do that. But as we said, this year's events are going to be on June the 23rd for the Marion County, Washington County event mm-hmm. at the Lebanon Springfield Airport. And then the Nelson County event will be on June the 30th. And stay tuned, we have interviews coming up with the representatives from the various different Relay for Life events, kind of giving us more details about mm-hmm. what's going to take place on those dates as well, and all the details on that. But before we do that, we wanted to go take a look back. So here's a little video of last year's Relay for Life events that we've covered in Marion County, Washington County, and in Nelson County. And again, the venues are going to be the same this year for those. It'll be second years for them. But it kind of gives you an idea, if you've never been to one of the events, what to expect. And then keep tuned in each week leading up to the events. We'll have more interviews and videos and talks with the teams and the members who are making this possible.
Okay, sounds great. You know, Gary, too, I'd like to say this about our coverage. One year, I don't know if people remember our co-worker, Beth Oberhau. Mm-hmm. One year, I helped her cover it in Nelson County, and we had a wonderful time talking to all the different booths, like I said, different teams and all that. And she did sign up that day to have on her driver's license, you know,
to be an organ donor.
And I'll never forget that. She was such a giving person, and we all, you know, have, you know, people in our lives that are givers, but Beth was a continual giver, you know. And I just wanted to bring that up, let everybody know that if you would like to do something like that too, hopefully, you know, they'll have that same booth out there this year in Nelson County, and you'll be able to do the same if that's your desire.
Absolutely.
Hi, I'm Gary White here with
Wilma Sorrell.
And we're at the Nelson County Fairgrounds, and we're here for the Nelson County Relay for Life 2017, a new venue this year.
Yeah, it's new. They've held it at Barstown High School for the past several years. This year, they wanted to revamp it, bring it out to the Nelson County Fairgrounds, and from the looks of it, it's a great venue to have it at.
Absolutely. Yeah. And we can see behind us some of the different booths that are set up, as well as some of the teams. We're going to go around and get a chance to talk to some of those teams. And you're also friends with the lady who coordinates all this, right?
Paula Simpson. I think she's been a chairperson. This is her second year, and she's, you know, they've had some low attendance years, and I think they just wanted to revamp it. And so their whole committee came up with some great ideas to just kind of breathe some new life in Relay, which, of course, this is for a great cause.
Right. This is for the American Cancer Society, and it's the fundraiser they're having here for over 20 years in all the different counties. And this year, as we said, they have it here at the Nelson County Fairgrounds. Also, it's only on Saturdays from 12 to 12, where normally it had been on like a Friday and a Saturday.
Friday evening, and Saturday wound up around noon or 1 o'clock on a Saturday. So yeah. I like this all-day venue, and especially we have gorgeous weather.
Absolutely.
Gorgeous weather.
We lucked out on that.
We did luck out on that. So I think it was a blessing for their first year to move out here to have great weather.
And you can hear in the background, too, they're going to have bands and music all day long as well with some of the local talent.
Yeah, and I think they're going to have some karaoke later, different bands come out and provide some wonderful music. As you can hear, the music right now is just amazing. And, you know, it's games. They've got food set up out here. I think the pork producers maybe mm-hmm. cooking. So,
okay. And I see some old cars, so I think the Whiskey City Cruisers are out here too.
The Whiskey City Cruisers are out here, from my understanding, and I think they're going to probably be coming in and out all day with some different cars.
Well, let's go see what we can find out.
Let's do that.
I have
Jessica Sachs and her dad, Curtis Ballard. They have this gorgeous pink Peterbilt truck out here at Relay for Life today. So I know there's an interesting story about how this truck came to be in your fleet. Give us a little bit of rundown about how this happened, Jessica.
Well, we decided it was time to expand our business a little bit. We were going to be purchasing some new trucks, and one of our drivers, Mr. Jim Caldwell, he was going to be one of the ones that was going to get a new truck. And so he requested that we get a pink truck, kind of in honor of his wife, who passed away from cancer 5 years ago this month, actually. And so, you know, we worked with him and with the Peterbilt guys and got him his cancer awareness pink truck.
And it's got the pink ribbon on there. And so did you all have that painted specially for the Ballard Transport?
Yes, we worked with Kerry Signs here in Bargetown, and they helped design that and got that put on the truck for us.
Well, from talking to your mom, and I know from just watching your dad's face right now, that this also has a special meaning for you.
Yes, I'm a cervical cancer survivor. And, you know, so when Jim came to us and said that he wanted a truck in memory of his wife, it really meant something special to me too, because I know what an impact that cancer has on not only on the survivor, but also on the family.
Well, I know, looking at Dad over here, I know this truck has to make you proud.
Yeah, you know, it's just, you know, Jim been a loyal employee for many years, and when he came up with the idea, I just thought it was great to be able to do that, you know, for him.
And you have to paint a truck, so might as well be this beautiful pink with a ribbon.
<That's right. laughs> I think it's a pretty truck as well.
I think it's gorgeous. And you know, I noticed you all have like another semi here with a trailer, a booth. Tell us a little bit. It looks like a survivor for cervical.
Yes.
Give us a little bit of idea about what that's about.
Well, as being a cervical cancer survivor, I connected with the group called Survivor, spelled C-E-R-V-I-V-O-R, a little play on survivor and cervical. And they are a support and advocacy organization, really works on educating people about cervical cancer and HPV and what you can do to prevent cervical cancer, because cervical cancer is actually one of the only cancers that is preventable through the HPV vaccine and regular pap smears and HPV tests.
And I think that's important, because we just had a an interview with Paula Simpson, and we were talking about the funds that is raised through Relay. So a lot of that's research. I have a feeling that yours was caught early because of routine testing and research.
Yes, absolutely. You know, that's those routine tests going in for your annual exams, getting the pap smears, getting your HPV test, and talking to your doctor. You know, if we do that along with the HPV vaccination, we can potentially eradicate cervical cancer within the next generation.
So. That's I love your booth, I love the truck, and I think our viewers will appreciate that your company took such great strides, and we're gonna say, you know, the strides to prevent cancer or to overcome cancer, to really support this in such a tangible way, where when that truck's going down the road, people are like, that's just says something about your family and your company, and how that relationship was formed with your driver.
Yeah, you know, it's good PR. You know, that's just a plus for us to be, you know, get the PR out of it, and, you know, and with the driver and Bob, and it's just great.
So where's your driver at today? He's not here?
No, he is actually on the road doing a load out to California.
Well, we want to wish him from Central Kentucky TV, we want to wish him the best. We know this is the 5-year anniversary of his wife passing away from cancer, and we know that is probably such a traumatic time for him, and I'm sure you help keep him busy and keep him just rolling down the road.
Yep. Starting next week, he'll be rolling in this thing.
Oh, so this truck goes to him next week.
Yes, it does. It will be on the road, going out west, going all around Bargetown. It'll be going everywhere. So
if you see the pink truck, you know it came from the Ballards, and you also know that it is bringing awareness on a different level about the cancer and cervical cancer. I don't know what type of cancer his wife had.
I'm not sure.
But it's just bringing the awareness on the road, so to say.
Yeah.
But we appreciate everything you all have done.
Yes.
thank you so much.
Thank you.
Good luck and congratulations on being a survivor.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
I'm with Linnell from Tower Automotive. We're at the Barstown Nelson County Relay for Life. Linnell, I noticed that you all are the first, a new team this year, and you have a booth. Give us a little bit of information about your booth.
We are running the bouncy houses for the kids today. They actually can pay $5 and have unlimited jumping all day long. All the proceeds go to our tower team for the Relay for Life.
So you have a couple Tower Automotive personnel over there. So are they coming back and forth or different times of the day?
Yes, we have volunteers. Our colleagues have been so generous this year with their money and their time, and they will rotate throughout the day and come and man the bouncy houses and play with the kids.
Well, since my last question to you, since this is your first year, what made you all decide to do the relay this year?
We had been involved in relay several years ago and with a previous employer, and I think it's a great cause. And so we worked together with the colleagues and joined together and had a team, and we're really proud of them.
That's awesome. If you're a company out there, I know I work for Fuji as well. I think a lot of companies are starting to get involved with the relay. So that's an awesome thing for the companies to come out and support their community like that.
Thank you,
Linnell, with Amy Mattingly at the Barstown Nelson County Relay for Life. And so she's with the HOSA, H-O-S-A. What does HOSA stand for?
HOSA stands for Health Occupation Students of America.
And you are with Nelson County High School?
Actually, the Nelson County Area Technology Center.
Okay.
So we have Nelson County High School students as well as Thomas Nelson and Barstown.
Okay. So I know we have a group of students back here that is with HOSA. So what schools are you all with? Do a quick shout out.
Thomas Nelson, Barstown, Nelson County.
Perfect. So we have representation from all the three, well, two of the county schools and the Barstown City Schools.
Yes, ma'am.
So what made you all decide to set a booth up, and what do you all, have you all started fundraising before today?
We have started fundraising. We have we've done a split the pot, so half will go to the winner and half will go to Relay for Life. We've had donations, so we have a UK and U of L raffle basket, and then of course we're selling some goodies, so all those proceeds will go to Relay for Life. And we are doing this because we want to give to the community. We want our HOSA to be a club that is known in our community for helping others, and so that's why we decided to do this.
I think that's great to have the youth out here today and representing a good fundraiser like this and a good group as Relay is. With your booth and stuff, how much money do you expect to raise over the course of your fundraising efforts?
Well, I'm hoping a lot, but since this is our first year of doing this, it's kind of just what, you know, we'll be happy with whatever we can contribute.
So this is you all's first year?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So how many students have been involved throughout this process?
HOSA has a total of 50 members for all three schools. So,
do you have students coming in and out throughout the day?
Yes, ma'am, I do.
Okay, mm-hmm. Perfect. So, any ladies want to add anything? Are you excited about being here today?
Yes. I'm excited. I'm very excited.
So, what makes you excited about being here at Relay?
You know, I just love being a part of HOSA. This is a great club to be a part of, and I've never experienced Relay before, so it's kind of the first thing for me and my club.
I know you all do Instagram, Twitter, something like that. Have you all been sharing it on there to get people to come out?
Mm-hmm. We have the event on Facebook, so we've had a lot of people been sharing it on there and just different resources.
All right. Well, I think we have a great representation from our youth, and Ms. Mattingly, thank you for organizing these groups. And I know the Relay Committee appreciates everything that the schools are doing.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Thanks for interviewing with us today. Thanks, ladies.